All right, welcome back to Morning Live, still coming to you live from the Free State province in Bloemfontein, to be specific, at Neville Hill. That's where the Macufe launch is, or the Mangaung Cultural Festival is officially being launched here today. So earlier we spoke to the HOD of the Department of Arts and Culture, who was basically saying that Macufe is not necessarily a music festival, but they're trying to promote arts and culture within the province. With that said, there is also a place called Craft Market. It's just down the road here, and that's where our colleague Palesa Mweti is. It's over to you, Palesa.
You're back at Pekoff's here, where we've got three guests on Macufe right now. First up is Barry Swanepoel, who is the Director of Arts and Culture here in the Free State, and he's going to be talking to us about the homebrew program. Barry, thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Palesa. Yes, you know, Macufe has two distinct sections, the commercial section and then the homebrew section. Now, the homebrew section is all about local content and showcasing local content. So what we do during the year, we travel to all five districts in the Free State. We do selections, and then the best of the best come to Macufe as a provincial platform for them. So we are constantly advocating for new talent and raw talent that we can develop to bring to Macufe.
Thank you very much, Barry Swanepoel.
Just a pleasure.
Thank you. Joining us right now, again, is also Khwezi Mampolo, who is the Deputy Director for Performing Arts, Visual, rather for Performing and Visual Arts and Crafts here in the Free State Province. He's going to be taking us through the details of this homebrew program.
Thank you, Palesa, and the viewers at home. Homebrew, this year, having been declared the year of the artist in the Free State, we have quite a big program. We have the Macufe Arts and Craft in the corner, Macraf and Elizabeth, where you have about 80 exhibitors from the Free State who are exhibiting their products there. And in addition, you also have a program called My Stage, My World, which covers mostly your live bands as well as your plug and play musicians. Then when you come to Pekoff's, in Studio One, we have four dance contemporary dance productions that will be happening during the course of the week. And then next door on Studio 2, you will be having four theatre productions, as well as in Musicon, where you also have theatre productions happening there. Then in the Andre Ignot Theatre, you have Kari Musical by one of our legends, and Tate Mosley Shuti, who is producing it. And then later in the week on Friday, you will then have Poetic Blues, which is your mainstream poetry. And then we also have a reggae festival that will be happening on Thursday back at Macraf. And on Tuesday, we have a full program for correctional services, where we say we are creating a platform for our inmates to also try and interact. Then at Nalan Museum, we have an exhibition, a visual arts exhibition of Fidel Castro. These are rare pictures that has never been seen. So we are accommodating it there. The entrance is free. And then when you go to Old Presidency Museum, we also have the visual arts from the Free State. We call it Free State Arts Talk, where you have all the collective of visual arts from the Free State exhibiting there. So it's quite a program that will be happening throughout the week. We starting from the 2nd of October until the 8th of October. It's a packed program, and the entrance for the theater productions is only 30 rand, and Poetic Blues is 50 rand, and other entrances are free. So everybody is invited to come and enjoy. This is a fully packed program. We also have a storytelling program where we accommodate families and children to come and enjoy. So we are trying by all means to make sure that this year, as the year of the artist, we give a platform and we entertain our people.
Thank you very much, Khwezi Mampolo. Now also joining us is Boitumelo Khumalo. Boitumelo is a crafter, and she has some beautiful things that she's brought just to show us, you know, what she has done. Just, would you want to take us through your role in Macufe? Let's start with that.
Okay, I'll be at the exhibitions, one of the 80 exhibitions that Mr. Pulu mentioned, where we'll be selling our products. And then these are my products from Leather Empire. These are some of the products you'll find there, some with the beading and the and other leather crafters and you know, everything that you might think of that is made with hands.
Okay.
Yes.
And for somebody like yourself, mm-hmm. Macufe, what does it mean in terms of you growing as a business person?
Oh, it's a pleasure to always sell at Macufe because it happens annually and you get people to come in and get to see your products, you know, nationally, even internationally in most cases. So it's really a pleasure because for us, with as a SMME, you know, you get to grow because this is like right now I'm on TV and they get to showcase my products. So it's just growth all the way, growth all the way. And we are very pleased. Thank you very much.
Okay, but tell me just lastly, do you get enough platforms as a crafter here in the Free State to be able to sell your products and get them out there?
Yes, we do. You know, we have places where we're working from. We get shops. Some of our products are in other shops in town. We even social media help us where, you know, people can locate us. So we do, yes. And we would really honestly love to have events like this happening more oftenly during the year.
Thank you very much, Bitumelo.
Thank you very much, Palisa.
Kumalo, for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you. With that, it's back to Naval Hill with Palisa Chubisi.
All right, thank you so much, Bitso. That's our colleague, Palisa Mwete, live from Macufe here in Bloemfontein, where we're still launching the Mangaung Cultural Festival. So, Kichola, earlier on, hore, itlebe sa fella hai sna di artists, because it's all about them from today. Today is Friday. It's the Tsepe Festival. Tsepe Festival today. Good morning. Welcome to Morning Vibe.
Hey, I'm good. Yeah, Tsepe Festival today at the Dome. Tickets go for 110. Gates open at 4.
I was just saying good morning to you. But nonetheless, I don't know how to get out because I don't know how to get out.
Yeah, like, thing is, Tsepe, there's a lot of segments within the Tsepe sound. No one? Yeah, there's the Soto sound, there's the English sound I'm doing. Tsepe just means like freestyle.
So you're doing the English sound, my man. You're doing the English sound.
Yeah,
but there's also a sort of sound.
Yeah.
But what can your fans look forward to today?
I mean, like, we have new music, new sound. I'm introducing new music, mixing it with the stuff they didn't know already, you know. Yeah, they must expect fire. Bombs on stage right now.
All right. What is new that you're bringing today?
I have a new song called Hamnati Joan that's been doing proper, that's been doing well on radio.
How does it go?
I just took the baby to the face, it just got me buzzing. Told him, bring another one, we got it. It ain't nothing, told me buzzing, got me. Yeah. Hey, Hamnati Joan. I mean, just come through, you hear the song. Yeah.
You know, don't give them out too much, it's fine. Yeah. They'll see you today at the Dome?
At the Dome. Yeah, gates open at 4. Gates open at 4. That's me, 2020, Castino, representing Free State, Jacob, against Dallas, Ricky Rick, Gemini Major. I mean, like, the list is endless. Yeah.
Fela hotla tswa Musi today.
Yeah, Musi, fire.
All right, there you have it. That's Nature. Catch him today at 4 p.m. Yeah. At the Dome. Tickets are already on sale. So if you are a hip-hop fan, to be specific, yes, so true, Tsepe and so on, make sure that you do get your ticket today. Now, where do I go? Ladies first, huh? Or should I go there? The Gospel Festival this coming Saturday. With me here is one of the artists who will be performing, Papa Karedi. Papa, good morning and welcome to Morning Live.
Good morning. Thank you for hosting me.
And thank you so much for your time. Where now, what can your fans look forward to on Sunday?
We're doing gospel. I'm representing Free State Extravaganza. So it's happening this coming Sunday. We have the likes of Dr. Tume, Rofiwa, Jerry, Kiurapetsi Melamu Metsi, Papa Karedi. So it's happening. So people should come, yes.
And again, it's about Hotlala Hahulu, tickets are always sold out. Do you know anything on the ticket sale right now?
Not yet, but I understand this week tickets have been sold, yeah, that much, yeah.
All right. But what can your fans look forward to?
They can expect success out of Sunday festival. Yeah, it's been success over the years, but we are lifting up the standard this coming Sunday.
In what way? How are you lifting up the standard?
In terms of the people who are coming, like some of the performing artists, like Free State Extravaganza, we gathering a number of artists from the province. We're bringing them together in one performance as a group. So it's fire. It's gonna be nice. Yeah.
Gospel fire.
Yes.
All right. Now there you have it. Let me speak to Bonolo. Dinchebile dimpotsa dipotsa wa dipo
eh di go tla fihlaneng sehlohlolong
ke fihlaneng sehlohlolo
a o se wa chivile ke sona sehlohlolo seo.
All right, Bonolo, wena o tlo performa kae?
Ke tla be ke le Divas concert on Friday.
Just Divas concert, my favorite of them all. And it's so unique in its own way. And ke tsaba e ratwa ke bo o se boholo. I don't know if ke bona di diva kapa ke lona di diva, but what can your fans look forward to?
What's one, I love performing indoor. I think it's intimate, you know. Festival ke ga perform empa ke rata indoor haholo. So my fans can expect Bonolo apparently time ka divas ke lo ba ngwana na mosotho hantle ke tlo apara thetana ke na le bomme ba apereng dithebetha ke na le bontate ba mokorotlo.
And we're still celebrating Heritage Month. In fact, we're wrapping up Heritage Month now. Specifically, why are you going that route? Yeah, I mean, we always see the ladies in heels, short skirts and all of that during the divas concert, but you're taking a different route. Why is it so?
Ke rata Sotho sa ka haholo, and ebile South Africa mona ke re ebile Sesotho se batla se saletse moraonyana Sexhosa, Sezulu ntse di le ka pelenyana wa bona. Jale, I would really like to promote Sesotho jalo ka bona botshepi wa bona.
Fela ho etsahalang ka Bonolo hona jwale, any album coming out soon?
Ke tsekele busy ke recordile Pina Barke Woman. It was inspired by Women's Month in Afitang. Yeah, ke tsekele busy ka yona, and then after Pina yo the full album.
Now there you have it, some of the artists who will be performing. Bonolo is performing next week Friday at the Divas concert. O tla ba aperetse thana a bontsha Bosotho ba hae, and Papa Karedi le yena will be performing this coming Sunday during the Gospel Festival, which is usually sold out. I do know that a lot of people goes to the Gospel Festival on Sunday, and a lot of ladies including me goes to the Divas concert on Friday, and we also had Onesha as well. But I think the focus really today is on Tsepe Festival that takes place at the Dome, like Onesha was saying earlier on. Let's talk to one of the organizers of the festival, Nyakalo, aka Batho Kadaliina. Good morning to you and welcome to Morning Life.
How are you?
I'm all right, and you?
Kimnati, Ntwana.
Kia tumela, and things, I believe everything is on set. Dintodi, hotlatswa musi today.
Macufe aqala kajeno. For the past few years, Macufe hantle ntle netsa la hantle ka last weekend. So we're very pleased to know that starting, I think, for the past 3 years, like the first day of Macufe, di tloaka fire. Re tloaka tshepe representing the Sesotho sound, the Free State sound. Obviously, we had a gap in Anaya, the type of identity in terms of music for young people for the province. So that's how tshepe actually came about. So re qala ka power for the past 5 years or so. For the past 4 years or so, we always had a full house, sold out shows. So we're actually expecting the same tonight.
Yeah. Talk to us about the idea Batokada behind Tsepe. And then you sort of introduced Tsepe through your Lesedi FM youth program between 3 and 6. But how is the reception, especially from the young people?
We had a problem in language in Apalisa, whereby if people like us were not taking the, you know, taking a stand against that, we are going to have a problem. We will lose our language. So it was not for our boys and girls, our young people. So we wanted to say you can be cool to Obama Soto, you can be cool to Repaka Soto, because like you said, Deben, they're doing it in their old language. Eastern Cape, they're doing the same. Gauteng, Northwest. So there was a gap in terms of music to do it fashionable Soto, because how nantu epotango kapo how kono hoba free how yetsaka language in Western Yao. So it was all about that, to open up market was Sesotho, because there was a gap for that market. So that's how we came about to Harry Pushenka Sesotho. So obviously it's not only a Free State in a leading Totsengata. So we tried to element identification identity as Free State.
There was a gap, there was a market, there was a need, there was an opportunity, and there is most definitely money. But to kada kapajwa.
Rabula, bo nature, bo castino, bo mambo mangi, bo kaspanyo vestibule. Bausan, you know, because at the end of the day, inspiration on Almore Nkante. So through the platform radio, I thought I will spearhead the campaign and the movement to be the face of these boys. Even if it happens that it'll push her after 10 years, but it'll be a better role. So about tonight at the Dome, we represent Macufe officially at Kala Kajeno, Reabola at Sepe versus New Era.
No, I'll tell you what, you're doing a great job. I know the reception is very good. I'm a fan. See you at the Dome today. See you at the Dome.
I'll go to the Dome now. 4 o'clock, Real Kala. I'll go to the Dome until 2 o'clock. Thank you.
All right, just a quick one. Talk to us about the lineup quickly.
Reabola at Rick, Dales, Gemini. There's also El Tido representing New Era. For Ronagna Landrianto, Jacob, Nature, Castino 2020, Flame Washa, DJ Capital, DJ Shakes, DJ Sleek. I mean, we're the only show with about 80% local, Majita local. So we are very proud of that.
Tip.
Get down.
Okay, I hear that's Nyakalo, aka Batokara Lino, Lee, talking to us about the Tipi Festival taking place today at the Dome at 4 o'clock. So make sure that you do get your ticket. Well, we're taking a break. Money Life continues after this. Don't go away.